So, could you briefly introduce yourself?
I'm David Leventhal. I'm the program director and one of the founding teachers for the Dance for PD, Dance for Parkinson's program at Mark Morris Dance Group in Brooklyn, New York.
So, how do you create bridges between public and audience and artist?
I think the key is to create spaces where there can be a conversation and an exchange between people who are working as artists already and members of the general public who have maybe never been invited to be part of an artistic conversation but are hungry to do so. For people with Parkinson's, I think that hunger comes from a desire to explore movement in a different way, to explore creative problem solving around movement, and to carve an identity for themselves that is not about the disease, but is actually about a whole person being themselves, feeling confident, feeling that they have something to contribute. And so in that space, we decided to bring together professional dancers, people who dance their whole lives, and people with Parkinson's who maybe hadn't experienced a lot of dance, and figure out what information we can exchange. I think the key to this is that from the very beginning, we welcomed our participants as dancers and not as patients. And so thinking of them as dancers who are there to gain more experience in the world of dance is critical to our overall philosophy and really helps to build that bridge from the very first experience together rather than seeing these separations or silos.
And what barrier do you have to deal with?
Well, one of the challenges we have right away is that a lot of people are scared of dance. They see the word dance and they think, I can't do that, or that's for somebody else, or I don't have the training. And one of the things we're very passionate about is the philosophy that anybody can dance, anybody can dance, that it's our role as people in the dance field to make dance accessible to anybody who's coming into it. That's our role. That comes from applying rigor and artistry to the process, not by watering things down or by dumbing things down. So from the very beginning, we're teaching technique, we're facilitating learning of creative repertory, of Mark Morris repertory in our case, and that I think is appreciated by the participants because they are right away brought into this world as co-creators, as dancers, and there's no separation. Yes, we're changing the speed that we're teaching, we're changing the difficulty of things at the beginning, but we are seeing this very much as an artistic space, creative process, and that all of the work that happens there is artistic work.
And what about sustainability of this project? How do you build it?
Well, I think the key to the project was that the idea came from the community. So when we opened the Mark Morris Dance Center in Brooklyn in 2001, we opened our doors and said, come on in. You're out there. We know you're out there. Come on in. And one of the people who came in was a woman named Ole Westheimer, who is the founder and director, was the director of the Brooklyn Parkinson Group. And Ole had this idea that people with Parkinson's could learn a lot from dancers, and the dancers could learn a lot from people with Parkinson's, but that the program would be sustainable if it was about dance and not about Parkinson's. And so from the beginning, it was an idea that came from the community, so it wasn't something that we invented and then waited for people to come. So we already had a built-in community, and then throughout the process, we have prioritized the act of listening. I think sustainability and listening are very related. Where I see programs go astray is when people who are running the programs stop listening and they just think that they have to do their thing. So throughout, we listened. First, we listened to participants who said, we want more classes. So we created more classes. Then we listened to teachers in other cities who said, we would like to do this work. How do we do this? So we started a training program. Then we listened to people who were stuck at home who really wanted to dance but physically couldn't get to a class. So we created DVDs and a live stream program. So all of that came not from the sort of this think tank of we have to do this, we have to do this, but really having our ears open and saying what are the needs of these different constituencies that we're working with, And how can we as an organization start to fulfill those needs with the same kind of quality and attention to detail that we've brought to all aspects of the program?
Thank you so much.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.